Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the DreamHack Stockholm Counter-Strike Global Offensive Tournament. We are live here from Stockholm, Sweden, and the winner of this match, Anders, is going to go and play in the Globen tomorrow.
Yeah, definitely a bit of an honor. If you can get to do that, you're going to be happy about what's going on, so yes. And this is not going to be an easy match. The best of one, LDLC and NiP. NiP might be the favorites here, but this is going to be a close match.
This is going to be sick. LDLC taking out Titan as well and managing to survive the storm. That's going to give them a huge boost of confidence. And I think in this group, Titan were the tougher team to play against for LDLC, because LDLC versus NiP, they're confident. They know they can beat NiP.
Yeah.
They're definitely very confident in their game. There was just so much emotional friction going into that match versus Titan, exactly, that, you know, I think that was going to pose more of a problem than the actual game. When it comes down to facing off against NiP, LDLC should be able to take it.
Yeah, I think so. Any time you have Shoxi on a team, you can never really count that team out. So I think it's going to be just a really enjoyable experience. We'll be on Inferno as well. Actually, I think that map might give NiP a slight edge because I think it's a little bit harder for a new team to play on Inferno. I think that's like if it ended on Dust 2, I think LDLC would have been a little bit happier. But it's not a big deal. Slight edge for NiP here.
NiP also have a bit of the edge, you know, just like home turf. They've got a bunch of people watching behind them. You can see them all laughing away. They're going to be really happy about this matchup as well, because Titan have got them dialed in existence, etc. They know how to take out NiP. Whereas LDLC might be a little bit tougher, but as far as LDLC are concerned, on their side of the map right now, they're confident. They're confident going into this match, and they know that they can really take on NiP. So this is going to be one hell of a match, about as good as it gets for Group A right now.
It's exciting, isn't it?
And I'm hyped. This is going to be so good.
Right, playing Globen tomorrow. Feels like it'd almost be a crime if NiP don't go there. But then if they lose this match, then not like they're out. They still get one more chance to play, right?
Double elimination format in the groups. So you win two, you're through. You lose two, you're done. You're out. So after this is going to determine who goes on to the consolidation match.
Yeah.
But right now, after this match, we have Titan versus Alternate to see who's going to be the first team going home from this tournament.
Yeah.
So you have on the one side, you have a team that's going to be going on to play off against one of the biggest stadiums in Sweden, one of the coolest ones as well. Looks like a giant golf ball, and because golf balls are cool, right? And then on the other side, you have a team that's potentially going to be going home, Alternate versus Titan. That's going to be a really tough match.
Yeah, it will be. And we do see LDLC setting up here on the other side, still with Shoxi and Happy and MBKs. They're all there. They're all ready.
They're looking dialed in as well. Kiyoshima with an excellent performance. You can see him there with the hat on backwards. Kiyoshima, younger player, less experienced, but Shoxi himself has said he's a very smart, talented player, and he wanted to continue playing with him. Kiyoshima, you know, we've seen him actually just top frag so far against Titan, and that's kind of what he needs to be on this team to do, really. They're going to be counting on him to play aggressive, go out and hunt for the frags, and when it comes down to it, secure those rounds for the team.
That's what it's down to. I'm wondering how LDLC are going to be playing Inferno. We sort of got a taste of what NiP did, and actually, NiP didn't have a flawless victory against Alternate.
It was bumpy. And you would put LDLC higher than Alternate.
Oh, definitely. So that makes you wonder. I don't know. This could turn out to be a bit of a struggle for NiP.
Yeah, and LDLC are going to be starting on the CT side as well. This is going to be very tough for NiP.
Yeah. Do you want to make a prediction? Do you want to make a bet? Do you want to put numbers on it even?
16-13 LDLC.
Oh, well, yeah, that's not a bad idea, actually. I'm just going to go 16-14 NiP then.
Aye.
Why not? A little bit closer. And maybe the Swedes. Home turf advantage, all that stuff.
This is the match. I didn't need the hat for the last match, but this is the match where I really needed the hat.
Yeah.
And sadly, it's like up north in my apartment right now, so I'm kind of sad about that. I don't have the hat. Oh, we have a hat. But no, it's not the hat, man.
Can't just pick up any old hat.
Can't just pick up. No, exactly. It's the hat of power.
Yeah.
You know, it's not some fake mock 2-bit French costume hat that's going to do the trick. It needs to be a legit hat. Legit beret.
So what it is.
Straight from the Bieber.
Guys, we're going to be doing Counter-Strike all day here from this channel. So cancel all your plans and watch Counter-Strike with us instead. Now, knife round's already been done. We're straight into the pistol. And look at this terrorist train coming down. And there are three CTs waiting. LDLC, they saw it coming, but it doesn't matter. Viflaren picks up a double assist with the one. And that is a pretty nice execution for NiP.
Oh, that's perfect. They managed to get in the range of the flash and just not get flashed. That's what it boils down to. So LDLC got flashed, NiP did not. And that totally backfires for the Frenchman. Get right's going to get overwhelmed by Shoxi, however, and Shoxi Still plenty of HP on him. He is one of the most lethal players in pistol rounds of the world round. He's going to spot out the man, Fiflarin, not quite landing the shot. He's down to half HP. He's going to spot out Fiflarin. Fiflarin still full HP, crouching behind an oranges, but NiP playing this perfectly. They aren't peeking. They aren't giving any targets here for LDLC to work with.
Shoxi still does get the kill. There's not a lot of time left now. They're going to move quick, much quicker than this. Shoxi comes in, has to reload, and he kind of, you know, pretends to defuse it once here. They're going to get the kills, but the bomb will explode, and that's going to be it. NiP winning that round.
Very scary indeed, NiP. That, but the way that worked out there, both like that was definitely a risk there by LDLC, having both of their players. They were just a second too late with that flash. The third man in, who was just at the entrance to B site, he was just a half second late with his flash. If it goes off half a second earlier, it blinds the entire NiP lineup. And with the CZs there, they murder everyone, LDLC. But it just backfires for them, and NiP managed to take the round.
Yeah, great double kill from Fiflarin to open it up. That made a big difference. But now they've got to be careful still. There is that scout. There's even a max 7 on Shoxi. So the Frenchmen are looking to bring it right back here, see if they can win the follow-up round.
Smith's already taken some damage from that boost, but Fiflarin gets tagged as well. So fairly even here right now. LDLC still patiently giving up ground, not playing too aggressively on B, holding in pretty standard positions right now. But it's going to be forced to find Smith. So that scout is now out of play for LDLC.
They sort of want to make it through, but the smoke there is going to hold them back. And there's actually another smoke on Happy, who's also over by this B bomb site. Oh. And that's a great shot through. NPK, how did he find that?
And that's a rifle that NiP have to worry about now. Get right getting back up there. He's going to probably chuck one Galil away and go and pick up Freiburg's. They don't want to be giving any rifles to LDLC unless NiP decide to go for B, in which case they can just push up here.
Thing is, if they go for B, then Happy, yeah, he's gonna put up another smoke here. This is a really good timing for Happy to find just 40 seconds as he puts it down. Get right, all the bullets are used, and Happy, the perfect timing. What a great game sense. And now it's gonna be the push towards the A bomb site. There are three people here for LDLC. Forrest coming in, he's gonna take down Kiyoshima. Still in the pit is Shoxi with that dreaded mag 7. And he misses the first one, goes for the repeat. Shoxi can do better than this. He's jumping, and he's not gonna get the shot here, Forrest. Finally taking him down, but it's going to be maybe too late. Happy comes in, and that's MBK with a triple, Happy with a double, and LDLC bring it back at a great round here.
Fantastic. They've managed to buy so much time. Shoxi may not have been landing the shots, but he certainly was buying a lot of time for his teammates to get in position, and NBK did not waste the opportunity, picking up two frags in that 3-on-3, bringing it down to the last man standing, Forrest, to get flanked by Happy, but Happy as well. I mean, LDLC are still clearly very much in control here. They're taking their time with their plays. They're outthinking NiP at that point. Get right. It's very rare indeed that you see Get right actually get outplayed so clearly.
Yeah. You have to imagine that Happy was just counting the bullets. Yeah. Like, he's got 35 bullets in, you know, and then with 6 left, he pushed out.
It was perfect, because Get Right, he goes for the spray point blank, and then he shoots 2 bullets, and he's out of bullets completely. Happy got that for free, so. This is
a real pleasure to watch. A real clash of the Titans here.
Get Right with a deagle. Not his usual style, actually. I think on Forest. Yeah, double deke.
Double dig. He's trying to hunt them down as well. Freiburg is here. Get Right just spraying away. He's going to manage to pick up Happy. He's going to have a rifle to work with now as well, but he's down to 6 HP. They go for the Fnatic smokes, though. They're just cutting up this site. NBK is going to be the only man here, and Forrest manages to point blank Smith. He's got a gun to work with now as well. It's got bullets in it. 10 bullets, 11 bullets. He could maybe take a fight, but Shoxi's cutting him up, and NBK will get shot from the site.
So if they could have found Kiyoshima, I think he was reloading then, so Shoxi would have actually had a good chance of doing it. But now Get Right very low on health here, and Kiyoshima is going to find him. So a little bit of a scare there for LDLC, losing a couple of members early on and almost losing Shoxi. But they hold on to 3 rifles, and we're still into the 4th round here, and NiP can't buy.
Yeah, NiP, exactly. Well, they spent all their money in that last round, right? So they were really looking to do some damage, and they did. They managed to pick up 2 kills, but that's not quite what NiP were looking for there in that round. They wanted to bounce back and really just shatter LDLC's economy. So that's not meant to be, and they're going to have to ego this round. Get Right is the only one to spend any money on his team, going up to a P250, so that's $300 invested on his part. But Smith's is currently pushed down. This is an aggressive play, a very aggressive play, in fact, from LDLC, and they're going to pay for it. Exist. He's going to get one frag. This could open up for the flank from second mid, but Shoxi manages to keep control.
Oh, Get Right in boiler room, and he almost gets that second kill, too. That could have been scary, but it works out all right. And at the very end here, they still lose a lot of members at LDLC, I think more than they needed to. So good idea with the aggression, but I'm not sure that they ended up fighting too many one-on-one fights there.
I think it was just Smith basically being hung out to dry, kind of. He was in a very awkward position standing there trying to push down to T-Pit. And the other problem was that NiP had guys wrapping around through second mid. So he was basically, his life was on a timer at that point. So really not the cleanest situation to be in. Shoxi with the AWP, though. Are we going to get a god moment here? Shoxi. Exist. Are you going to peek? Are you going to peek? There's the flash. And that's good play there by NiP. Working together, the teamwork. Clear the tag as well, CZ, but it's NBK who's going to get that frag.
Yeah, good teamwork coming out. NIP losing two members immediately, and that's going to be a big problem for them here. This is LDLC very close to taking a fourth round, and NIP would have to eco if they lose this one. That's the really scary part, unless they can get the bomb down.
Exactly. It's all about getting the plant, but they do have the smoke to block off Arch. Happy taking a little bit of damage as well. He's not going to be too pleased about that, but they've still got control of LDLC, and they've got four guys now rotated over to this A site. It's going to be very tough for NiP to crack in here. Good positions as well on the site proper. Smith's in the pit with Kiyoshima supporting him from balcony. So if NiP were to go up short, they're going to run right into Kiyoshima.
Oh, NBK can take now get right coming out of the apartments there. Just a bit of a peak. And now that brings it back a little bit closer. Only 30 seconds left and happy. Then easy kill on Forest there. Kiyoshima takes down get right and Kiflaren is going to fall as well. So that's another good double kill from Kiyoshima. And a pretty nice adjustment from LDLC.
Oh, they're looking really solid right now, LDLC. Not really shaking up too much here. Get right, looking pretty calm, composed. But not too much talking happening on NiP's side right now. They're looking very focused. It's still very early on in the half, of course. And NiP only really need five rounds in this T half to consider it a successful one. So if they can manage to get on that, there's still plenty of rounds to do it in. But there's going to be another round of eco here for NiP. One thing is the problem here for NiP is that they're starting to lose control of LDLC's money. And giving eco rounds to LDLC certainly isn't going to help things here. So LDLC, it's going to be basically LDLC being able to buy for three rounds before NiP can really have any kind of impact.
It is starting to look a little bit grim. And just noticing as well that Freiburg hasn't actually killed anyone yet here in the beginning of the sixth round. So, yeah, maybe, I mean, you can't really say NIP coming to this cold because they're definitely playing against alternate, but it feels like they're looking for that opening where they can really kick it into high gear and start playing like they should be playing.
Yeah, and well, LDLC certainly, like LDLC are going to be the sharper team in this sort of situation just because they came off of such a tense match versus Titans. And they beat the team basically that they wanted to beat. I mean, obviously LDLC come in here to win the whole thing, but Titan, scratching Titan off the list of victories, that's already a big accomplishment there. Exist is not going to get anything done there. And right now, LDLC are going to walk away from this with a perfect round. So getting a look at their money, it's really starting to get pretty nice here. Above 10K, just short of 10K for Happy. But the rest of them, all of them have enough money to go for a full buy in the next round, and they could even potentially force it up if they were to lose a third.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it's down to. One round where they lost only one guy, and then a flawless round in here, and it's looking really good into the seventh round. And NIP have AKs all around. Smith's going to go for the peak down middle. This time it's not Shoxi anymore or Ping, but it's one of the strengths of LDLC is they can switch it around a fair bit.
Now, they are pretty versatile. They are keeping Kiyoshima on short, and this is a change that was made recently. They basically want to put him in a position where he's going to be able to just kill a bunch of people. And short is that position. You've got control of Boiler, control of Quad. If anybody comes in through NiP, Kiyoshima is going to be that first line of defense here for LDLC. Smith playing Arch, this is exactly what you expect to see him do with that AWP as well. He's got so much experience as well. So playing that key position on Inferno CT, he's the man who's going to be deciding if he rotates over to B or if he's going to hang around A.
Now, if we go to second mid, yeah, look at this. Forest with the smoke. This is probably going to be a smoke that's going to... Well, actually, now he's putting over to Arch, so that's going to be really well against what Smith is doing here. Mm-hmm. Maybe they can zone him out, and that's going to leave it up to Kiyoshima and Shoxi, who's inside that bomb site. That would be a good start for NIP if they can get rid of the AWP, but Smith has moved four in front of the smoke, so now he's going to be... Well, yeah, he's going to be going back to a next corner here, where they could just smoke him off again.
Yeah.
And there it is.
Molly, exactly. That's perfect smoke. They're slowly but surely taking Smiths off this map, and they're going to go for a B split, and this is brilliant from NiP. They're poised here. Smoke, counter smoke goes down from existence. It's going to be NBK just barely managing to make it behind new boxes. Strong position from him, but now it's all about these two members here. They need to live as long as possible.
Yeah, Forest fries NBK. Happy goes down, and the bomb site is lost and still in the middle here. Get Right is waiting. Bomb goes down with 6 seconds left, and Shoxi is having a long and awkward battle here with Get Right and finally comes out on top, but I'm not sure that's going to make a big difference here. There's a 3-on-4 retake. Going to be very tough, I think, for LDLC to get in.
Yeah, Kiyoshima's taking point here. He's looking to try and find this frag on Force, but Force is just standing his ground, putting shots through on the edge. Smith is finally going to walk in with the AWP. He got tired of that joke, Force. And this is going to be Kiyoshima gets caught by Orange's Freiburg, holding a great position, but Smith finds another frag. We're into a 2-on-2. Freiburg will take him out, though. And now it's just Freiburg who's not going to last. Not enough time for the defuse, however, and Shoxi's going to go up with the bomb.
Yeah, that's a really, really great effort. And actually, he lands on the top on the arch there. That was very cool. Almost flew out of the map. That was a very, very cool attempt by LDLC, but it's not quite enough. So, I don't know. That's finally around for NiP, and it was a really good execution.
I'd love to see Maniac in existence back there, just watching, talking over what they see. But that, exactly. And that's a different thing. This is a different brand of NiP. And I'm wondering if this is PETA's influence coming into the game, basically, and saying, okay, let's start taking a look at how you guys can be a bit more methodical with your approach. Rather than just going for pick play, you take your time and you slowly cut up the map and make that work for you. Get right, just winning outright versus Shoxi there in that peak battle. That was very well done.
And BK hiding up here by the truck, the only one currently defending Banana, and that's going to be an easy kill on Freiburg. So, a good return, and we're back into a 4-on-4. You gotta wonder if they're going to keep trying something like that, because it was a pretty well mapped out strat from NiP.
It was
smoking Smiths all the way back, and then getting in through Archway.
But it's not often that we see NiP like this. That's something that NiP. That's a new way that NIP are approaching this. I guess it's not often that we actually see them go for slow, methodical play like that. They'll go for set smoke rounds, right? But to just take 40 rounds to execute something, 40 seconds to execute something, that's very interesting to see. This is NiP evolving right here.
Oh, look at this smoke down. And the really big thing is that Happy still has a Molotov. If NIP try and come through here, I think they're going to lose the round because of it. Unless Happy fails this Molotov, this is going to be almost impossible. Get Right could change that, but he's been caught already here in the CT spawn, and he's going to go down. Now when they rush through, they're running into the Molotov and taking a lot of damage for it, and Happy will pick off the one. Now it's Flamin and Forest left here. 2-on-3, 14 seconds left.
And they're just hopping right back. Not sure if he heard how close Biflarin was there. Biflarin right on the edge. Happy, he's going to find the angle, stops the plant. 5 seconds left. There's no time left. Forest, he has no time to win this round. The bomb is going to take too long to plant. Kiyoshima going to try and hunt him out. This is worthy. If he can get this kill, this could be big. Oh, and he just barely fails to do it.
The timing, that did everything. Happy put up the last smoke that he had in the bomb site where there was 38 seconds left. That in itself is a really good smoke timing. If you can do that with 38 seconds, that's really nice. Mm-hmm. And if you have a Molotov to spare, it's going to be really tough for NiP to make it through. The fact that he also kills Reflaren with 6 seconds is not at all bad. But yeah, Happy, 2 kills, definitely the man of that run around.
Yeah, absolutely. The key player, landing those key shots as well. But now LDLC are just looking very good. We have a force buy coming up behind Forrest, saving that AK. Forrest staying alive. It doesn't look like NiP are willing to try and, or they're not willing to let LDLC get back up to a comfortable level with their money. They want to try and do some damage here and win a round outright before LDLC get too confident in this half.
Well, I'm guessing NIP still have saved some money this round. Just, I think they've even, try and bring up the scoreboard real quick, see how much they got.
They didn't have enough. They didn't have enough. It's Get Right who has enough, but the all of them were floating around like two and some change, right?
It makes you wonder why Get Right hasn't gone for armor then too.
Yeah, that is actually a little bit odd.
That was what really confused me.
Let's see. Forest, Kiyoshima is going to make it out. I'm wondering if this is just going to be a straight-up B YOLO play here from NIP. They're gathering back down bottom mid, getting closer to Banana. Get Right is getting in his usual lurker role.
But again, Happy has that Molotov up, and I guess NIP actually do have smokes to cancel the Molotov this time. So that's not going to be too bad. The Molotov goes up right there, so NIP can make it through with just very few seconds left, and then Get Right again. Lloyd can go towards Archway. So basically the same thing they did last time, just with pistols instead of rifles, and Smiths and Happy shutting down this push really quickly. 10 seconds.
Yeah, not sure if they're going to expect these rifles, though. Are there the gear that's on NIP right now? The plant is going to happen in the smoke. Very clever play here. Exist manages to make it out intact as well, but damage has been suffered here by NiP. They're all fairly low. And LDLC are going to be closing in from all angles. Good methodical play here from LDLC, and they should be able to just clean this up.
Forrest dropping kind of low. He does pick up the one kill. He's still alive somehow and finally goes down, leaving Exist here. Been a pretty tough 1-on-3. Going to try and knife MBK coming into it, but the defuse will happen here. And it is going to be a 7th round for LDLC. Now a 5-round lead for the French team. Coming in, and definitely NIP is the first seed in this group. So, you know.
And I don't think that was enough damage dealt to LDLC's economy. three guys living through that is actually a bit too much there. NiP needed to kill off at least another two. Maybe if it goes down to like a 1v1, then okay, they lose that round, but they're still forcing LDLC to spend a whole lot of money in the next round. Whereas with three guys, you can always have the guy who's wealthiest just drop for the other one. It's going to have very little impact on the money. So LDLC is still in a comfortable position right now. They just have to focus on playing their game. NiP, however, because of that plant, they're going for a Hellraiser's buy. Like, very minimal nades. They're just going straight up rifles right now.
And I don't know. They've had some success with throwing a lot of grenades previously, so now they're going to try and just run in here. Shoxi is in a great position with this M4. They're going to be walking out. He takes almost down one, but the flashbang works. And now it's on Smith. Gets a good double kill. Kiyoshima with one. And now they actually have the bomb site. There's a real chance for NiP to make this crazy buy work.
Oh, is Happy going to be here close enough? Oh, he just barely misses out on Exist getting by. Trying to put shots onto that box. Exist turns away, hoping to dodge the bullets, and he does so. So we're into a 2-on-2 retake. This is excellent here. NBK working his way up short. Oh, NiP are in a great position.
They have a Molotov as well. Into the corner. Exist is going to have to move out. He's burning a little bit. They're down to 60. That's a lot of damage taken. And now Happy gets a chance. And actually, it's going to be through Flaren going down. Exist trapped in a corner. And they know exactly where he is because the Molotov, he's going to walk in. And Happy will get that kill. They had pretty much cleared the rest of the site with fire.
Yeah, that was good use of nades. LDLC not skimping. Not willing to really put it up. Happy going back over there just to make sure that Exist gets the message.
Oh, they're feeling great right now. You can see LDLC definitely very excited about what's going on, and I think they have to be. This is a great start to the first half here that they've got, and NiP are going to be ecoing once more. 8-2. The Frenchmen are looking strong.
They are looking very good right now. Although, because that was such an expensive round for them, we can see a lot of their money getting taking a pretty big hit there, so they aren't going to be pleased too much, but now they actually have an eco round here from NiP to bolster that. And Get Right, he does decide to spend the Kevlar, or the money on the Kevlar, $650. He had 1,800 after, well, he had a little bit more money than his mates, basically, so he's going to be able to spend a little bit here, and it actually works out. That CZ 75, now he's got Kevlar on an M4.
Yeah, the more damage he can do, the better, but actually winning it, he's got the bomb, but LDLC, I don't think, they're not playing recklessly right now. You know, they won't be giving him that many openings, essentially. Sharks are just walking in and getting the kill. But, one loss here is Happy, and that's it. 9-2. Well, we're moving right into the 12th round. Gotta say, I'm impressed and just delighted by LDLC playing so well here.
Yeah, they are definitely making a statement right now. I mean, after the French shuffle, the reshuffle in the teams, you know, everybody thinking, okay, Titan, team to watch, team to go for, LDLC. They're showing that, bam, they can beat Titan in a best of one in a group phase on land, and now NiP. They're within range. It's not over yet, though. You can never count NiP out. No matter the score, NiP, the reason why a big reason why they're one of the best, if not the best team in the world, is because they can constantly come back. They never give up. Never give up. So NiP, they may be down right now, but they certainly are not out. 9-2 the score. If they can get a couple more rounds in this half, they'll be pleased. It's going to be smokes sailing into this A site. However, Kiyoshima completely flashed. It's going to be Smith only just with the 1-for-1 trade, but then Happy comes in. Perfect spray from him. Shoxi will do massive damage to Freiburg. Drops him down to one, but this is a 2-on-2 retake now, and the rotation already coming in from NBK. He's going to get up in apartments fairly fast.
Yeah, this is a strong position for NBK, no doubt about that. Get Right, though, is actually in an equally strong position. I think it's going to come down to who spots who first, and NBK's winging about walking out. Can he coordinate with his teammate? That's a great headshot from Get Right. Turns around, and now Happy is in an awkward 1-on-2. He's being crossfired in here, and Get Right will take care of business. Pick up that double kill, and NiP get another round on the board. 9-3, that's good. And actually, there's not that much money on LDLC. I think they can force it up this round, but if they lose the upcoming round, then all of a sudden NiP is right back in the mix.
Yeah, exactly. They could actually finish this off pretty good. I mean, they could have a real crack at 9-6 here. So NiP, they could potentially turn it around. We have to see if LDLC are going to keep their nerve going into the end of this. Freiburg living with 1 HP, though, that made all of the difference in that round. Incredible that he manages to live. That changes everything, turning it into a 2-on-2 like that. NBK also very awkward with that smoke blocking him. But Get Right will find the opening. Smith is going to get caught out in mid. Again, a forward position there from LDLC. Not sure if that was necessary. And you're opening yourself up to getting punished like that, especially if your mates aren't exactly in ideal positions to back you up and get the refrag, which is what's so important. And NBK peeking out on Banana, trying to get information, as he should when you're down a man like this. LDLC need information, but he needed to win that duel.
And I look at Shox, just a lot of confidence walking all that way, not even scared a little bit. And that grenade to follow did a hell of a lot of damage, and now he's going to have to fall back into side. He did take down Exist, and Geralt's been dropped by Kiyoshima. It's not over yet here for LDLC, even being two people down. They fought their way back into a 3-on-3.
Kiyoshima sneaks his way back through across. He manages to get across. The smoke is going to give him the opportunity. And 35 seconds left. This smoke is going to hurt. Happy is up in apartments right now. He's going to be able to spot out Fifth Lauren. Does Fifth Lauren? Oh, he turns away at the last possible second. Oh, but he spots him at mid. It's all over the place, Anders.
If he peeks again, though, Fifaron could probably take him down. And there's the kill. Now it's back into a 2-on-2. Kiyoshima already with the one kill. Comes in, goes for the spray, takes down Forrest, and sees Fifaron. And Shoxi, 9 health is enough when you have an AWP. Fifaron going to go straight for the punt. He's going to be successful in that much. And then Shoxi's there, takes him out, and the LDLC are going to win the round. Absolutely amazing. That was a 5-on-3 turned into a victory.
Oh, that's incredible. Shoxi manages to find the angle. NiP, they get onto the site, and they get the bomb plant at least. Bonus 800 for everybody, but...
Yeah, but even that's not quite enough.
Yeah, they're all over the place with their money right now, NiP. Happy, yeah. I was wondering if Fifflaren spotted him there, but I guess Fifflaren didn't.
No, I think he did. I think that's why he's waiting outside here. Because he picked up the kill afterwards. I'm pretty sure he's waiting for Happy to go back in.
Happy getting the kill on both of his mates. That was impressive. Just... incredible game. This is everything we could have hoped for here for a winner match. LDLC 10-3 versus NiP right now. And if they win this round, LDLC, they're going to force NiP to eco in the last round of the half. That would be fantastic for LDLC. That could potentially be a 12-3 finish for LDLC right now.
Now, you see a tiny detail from Shoxi there. The way he jumped over the middle with the AWP, he wanted to get up into apartments, but he spotted three NiP members that were looking at him down from ramp, and instantly he realized, all right, if I go up in apartments now, they're all going to be looking down from second mid. So he just went back and took a shot through the light pole down there, and actually took Freiburg down to 15. So it's a really good choice, smart individual decision-making coming out from Shoxi there.
Yeah, Shoxi clearly showing that he's on top of his game right now. And LDLC, all of them, it's looking like NiP are going to bum rush Banana. Fresh smoke goes down here for LDLC. NBK kind of holding the position here, but it looks like NiP have got a little bit of a cheap play here. Looking over the smoke, very clever, but instant kill, and NBK gets a double through the smoke.
Could get more than that. He's got the grenade out, unfortunately. 6 bullets left, and that's going to be the 4-man spray down, NBK. And now 11 rounds for LDLC. My God, that was such a great boost from NiP, and then the instant shutdown. NBK not inviting them into that bomb site.
Oh, that was a calamity. What perfection. And oh, that double spray right there, the double headshot through the smoke already. But then NBK, the angle that he holds, they think he's in CT right now. They're convinced he was in CT smoke. Oh, wow, NiP, that's just, well, I mean, NBK, perfect place to be, exactly. Random is right. It's just the perfect place for him to be. Now Kiyoshima is going to get overwhelmed. It's the force buy coming out here from NiP. They have to put everything into this round. They absolutely need this fourth round going into the second half.
Right, Smith's trying to do his best here, but he does get taken down after just the one. Shoxi, though, on the other hand, has already picked up 2 kills, and Exist will make it a 1-on-2. If he could find another kill, then maybe there's a chance here. Smoke's going to allow him to put down the bomb, but he's sandwiched in.
And now he's going to be forced out. Oh, he's going to look for Shoxi. Exist. He's just patiently waiting.
Yeah.
Shoxi's got a nade in his hand now as well. All right, there's the nade, but does Shoxi actually go for the pistol?
Exist gets the one kill, and now he's in a great position. This is hard for MBK. He's got the smoke, so maybe he could put it down and just try and force Exist out here. Smoke.
Oh, he's covered the defuse.
He's straight for it. Oh my God, 12-3. That is some very brave play. I thought for sure that was going to be more of an attempt to. He had another flash and another smoke. The one flash is all he needed, and then he just stuck to it. I did not see that coming, and I guess neither did Exist, and he's not looking happy right now.
They are not looking pleased right now, NiP. Not at all. And PETA's got to be the man behind this, you know, just covering them, talking to them. He's got to be giving them info as to what they need to be doing here in this T side. But NiP, they look very focused. Freiburg, not the best start to his half at all. So he's going to be looking to it. I mean, right now, Freiburg, 5 frags. Only 5 frags. That's, I mean, get right, Forrest. It was all over the place right now for NiP.
They had a lot of eco rounds in this first half. LDLC did a really good job of keeping their economy low. Now, pistol round or not, LDLC should still be in the driver's seat right here.
No, this is it. LDLC, this is a
I mean, it's not as good as it gets, obviously, 15-0, but still, 12-3, this is fantastic for them. If they can pick up the pistol, they can close the game right here. So this is everything now for NiP. NiP need to play perfectly. And, you know, you never count NiP out of a game, but there's Shoxi managing to find the first shot onto Forrest, and Forrest, a huge asset for NiP in pistol rounds. He's so very good. But Shoxi, one of the best players in the world when it comes to pistols.
Well, actually, so is Forrest. I think
him
and Shoxi are like the two of the best in the absolute world. So it's kind of fun that the initial battle is between the two talents right there. And Shoxi convinced that someone's going to come and peek him, but nobody will. I mean, well, at least we know that much. But this 4-on-5 here, in a pistol, it's much harder to play 4-on-5 than it would be in a rifle round. Because in a rifle round, they could have left Get Right alone here. But in a pistol, he kind of can't afford to do that. He's going to be peeking out against every single one from LDLC. That's a full 5-man rush coming in. And now it's Freiburg next in line. That's a great headshot. He needs a lot more right now. And he's going to miss the first shot there. And that's going to be the end of it. Now it's a 2-on-4.
Quick rotation in from Exist from Construction, though. He's going to be looking for a shot of his own. He can't stop that plant from happening. That would have been crucial there for him to pick that up. But now it's going to be Fiflarn and Exist trying to cut this side up in a 2-on-4. There's no backing off. This round is so important for NiP. They need to land the best shots of their lives right now to pick this up and get them that first seed. But right now it's going to be Fiflarn finding Happy. One good kill there. He gets a second one as well. NBK gets caught, and Exist is closing in on Shoxi.
There's not so much time left here. Shoxi has to stay alive just a little bit longer here. He's got the triple already, and his double, in fact, sorry, and Exist, well, out of time, out of bullets, and they're going to have a manly fight in the middle of the explosion. Shoxi gets the knife kill, $1,500 and a triple, and that is a bit of a statement, humiliating NIP.
Oh, that was amazing. Shoxi and Exist actually having a knife fight in the face of an explosion. You don't get any cooler than that. Gift should be made right there. But that is, I mean, Shoxi just got a huge amount of money as well, $1,500 for that knife frag. And that's exactly what Exist was looking for as well. He's like, okay, if we lose the round, if I can get an extra $1,500, this would be big for us. But it's actually, everything goes wrong, and LDLC are the ones to pick it up. Exist has got a scout of his own right now, and he's got to get the headshot on NBK. So NiP definitely not giving up.
No. And NBK may be pushing a little bit too far because he heard the first scout shot. Mm-hmm. You gotta wonder if it was really necessary for him to keep challenging, but LDLC are probably feeling a little bit hyped right now, and you can't really blame them.
No, and Exist, I mean, NBK, if he lands the first shot, he knows that if Exist went for a scout buy, he's got no Kevlar. So if he lands the first shot on Exist, Exist has got aim punch, he's gonna be all over the place, right? So then it becomes free pickings or easy pickings for NBK, but Exist, you're not quick enough to keep up with Exist, apparently, NBK.
No, quite. Smoke set up here towards the B bomb site. I'm wondering if it's going to be a bit of a fake because, yeah, you see everyone else rotating back towards the A bomb site instead. So Shoxi's just going to be a bit of a distraction, but, you know, the best kind of distraction is when you can actually kill people. It's a sure way to get their attention.
Absolutely. I mean, that's prompted the rotation out from Exist. He's going to be trying to cover the cross with that scout. Smoke should go down to block him off, however, and he's not going to be able to be too effective. Shoxi already trying to cut him off in construction. Dangerous position now. Exist is kind of just caught in a box at this point. He's got his mates rotating in from the A site, but Exist, Shoxi is just toying with him at this point. He's just making sure that Exist can't get in here.
Yeah, well, Shoxi single-handedly opening up the bomb site. He's eventually going to go down, in fact, Fiflarn coming with that kill. I think halfway through that fake, they decided, why fake it if we already have the bomb site? And then just went back and took it anyway.
Pretty much.
So, yeah, amazing job from Shoxi. He's at 23 kills right now, so he's doing a good job.
And NiP look very, very stressed right now. Fiflarn, Exist, Forrest, Freiburg, nobody really talking. Not a whole lot of emotion apart from, I mean, frustration, abject frustration.
Yeah, you know, I was going to say, they just look like they've been defeated already. 14-3 here. They're on Eco, and LDLC are going to have match and map point unless they run into some pretty good pistol work.
Yeah, this is what's going to be crucial now. Where exactly do they go? LDLC just looking to just swarm onto this A site. They've got all the firepower. They've got all the guns they need. Forrest up on balcony, and this is usually a very good position for him to be in. He can do a lot of damage. He decides to drop back into pit, the safer position to hold as well. It's going to be existence, or Exist rather, just getting caught over here at Arch. Kiyoshima will find Fiflarn, however, and the whole of NiP are going to converge on this A site, but they finally managed to get the first kill. Exist gets dropped to 14, but he takes NBK with him. And there's Forrest! He gets two! He's looking for a third one! He nearly gets it on Happy!
Oh, I think Forrest deserved that kill. That was very, very nicely done, but it doesn't matter. It's still a 2-on-2 here, and now Freiburg's going to go down Smith's with a great kill and Happy with a double as well. It is matching that point in spite of everything that Forrest just did then. It's not going to be enough, and NIP will have money to buy at least, but they're looking for 12 rounds in a row here, CT side, to force overtime.
Oh, that's
Exactly. Well, I mean, it's now 12 rounds. Can NiP do a 12-round comeback? But Forrest, man. Forrest. So calm. He ran out of bullets on the last one there. Happy just barely got it. That was so close. But Forrest, that's why we say that he is definitely one of the best pistol players in the world. His ability to get frags with pistols is insane. It's just that time, 1v, what, 1vx, it just wasn't enough.
They're pushing in. Freiburg will get the opening kill, but then the double return happens immediately. Shoxi fell down. And I actually think Shoxi has named his AK after his Twitter, at ShoxCSGO, so that's a really good idea. Exist will go down, and this is looking like it's all over for NiP. Bomb down, 2-on-4 retake. I think LDLC just schooled NiP on Inferno on LAN. Yeah. That's one hell of a statement to send.
Exactly. This is the best case scenario now for LDLC. They get first seed, and they will be moving on to compete in Globin, the main event tomorrow. Semifinals and finals will be played out there, and, well, they're going to play in one of the biggest arenas in Sweden tomorrow, Anders.
Yeah. Who's that skinny ginger person in the background that was there just before?
Did Pontus go over to Inferno?
Yeah, he did.
That dog.
That's Pontus from Fragbite, in case anyone doesn't know.
Yeah, they're all really... I mean, that's everything they could have hoped for there right now. LDLC picking up first seed is huge. Their day is done. The group phase is passed for them, and they have sent the perfect message out. The LAN performance right there that they were all looking for.
Yeah, stunning victory for LDLC. They've got to be really proud and happy shaking hands with a team or, you know, with players they've been playing for against a very long time. Mm-hmm. So it's gone either way for a while, but that was definitely impressive. NiP not going to be happy about this. That means they have to fight again to try and see if mm-hmm. they can make it to Globin.
Either Alternate or Titan, depending on who loses the next match that's coming up after this break. It's going to be Alternate and Titan.
Yeah, and if it's Titan, it's by no means sure that NiP can make it through that team either.
Do we get two French teams out of the groups? Is it the new happen. Era? You know, the Swedes, we're up aside now. It's time for the French to come in and dominate.
It could happen. This is really scary. But that's what it is, guys. We're going to be having a quick break before we go into the next match, which is going to be Alternate and Titan. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.